Hello students, now today in this session of class 12 business study, we will be going to discuss one more concept related with the directing function. Today in this session we will be discussing about one of the element of directing, that is supervision. So what is supervision? Supervision means overseeing the activities of the subordinate. It is a process in which we have to closely observe the various activities which are being performed by the subordinate and give them the instructions or the guidance from time to time to do that work in a proper manner. So supervision is basically a process, okay? That is the process which refers to the immediate guidance and the control of the subordinate in the performance of their tasks. This is the process of immediate guidance and control the performance. This is the process which is of immediate guidance and control the performance of the subordinate of the related task. Of the subordinate for related task. You have to provide them the immediate guidance and you have to control their performance and see that thing that the subordinates are performing their task in the proper manner. So that is the overall concept that is related with supervision. Now we will be also seeing that what are the various functions of supervisor. As supervision, it is most important part in the organization because for getting the work done successfully in a proper manner, the management or the managers have to supervise the various activities which are being done by their subordinate. So this highlights the importance of this function, that is supervision. So what is the role of supervisor? Okay. So what is the important role played by supervisor? So we have discussed all these things with the help of following points. We will be going through that discussion. I have already noted the points for you. In supervisor, importance first is face-to-face contact. There is a face-to-face contact between the two level person, that is the supervisory level and the lower level person, and they are giving them the proper guidance, okay, and they are directing them to do that work in a proper manner. So there is a face-to-face instructions or transfer of instructions which are taking place between the two person. Then comes an important link. Okay, supervisor, he is an important link between the two level, that is the lower level worker and the middle level manager. So he is the important link between the two levels and he tries to explain each and every need and the aspirations which are being required by the middle level management, and he tried to explain the grievances and the problems of the lower level workers also to the middle level management. So by this he becomes an important link between the two levels of management. Ensures the quality. He is the person who is responsible for ensuring the quality of the work, because he ensures that the products are strictly made in accordance with the standard which are being laid down by the organization. Giving guidance. From time to time he gives the guidance to the subordinate for completing a task or a given task in a proper manner. So he always guides the worker that how a particular task can be completed in a smooth manner. Giving feedback. He is also the person who is responsible for giving the feedback of the performance of their subordinate. Okay, So he keeps in mind the strong and the weak points of the subordinates, and then he gives the feedback to them that how these things can be removed or what are the various remedial measurement which can help them in removing their weakness, and they can increase their performance or the efficiency of doing the work. Then comes keeping up organization commitment. He is the person who has to see this thing that the task which is given to his group or his department is completed on time. So when the task of the department will be completed on time, so that means he is ultimately helping the manager in getting the work done on time, and by this the organization's commitment can be fulfilled that they are able to give the given task or they are able to perform the given task in a given time period. Suggesting the training program. He is the person who gives this suggestion to the HR department that from time to time the training program should be arranged for the workers. So he is the person who is responsible for giving this information that how many workers are there who needs the training and what type of training is needed by them. So how the arrangement of the various training should be made by the HR department. So ultimately by going through this point we can understand that supervisor is one of the most important thing in the management chain, and he is the person who is ultimately responsible for getting the work done in the proper manner by the workers. Okay? So hope you understand this concept that what is supervision and what is the importance of supervisor. Thank you and have a nice day.